Hi guys, and welcome back to Scribe Gaming. I'm your man Scribe, and I hope you guys are having a fantastic week. So we've had something really exciting happen in the Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes community as I am speaking. Well, you guys saw the intro. I mean, that was just me having a bit of fun. But the new community manager, CG Doja Fett, has actually come back with some proper communication, and I personally couldn't be happier, even though it kind of made me look like a bit of an idiot. I'm okay with that. Let's get into it. Alright, so let's kick this off. I woke up this morning and some people in my Discord channel were like, "Hey, Scribe! Scribe! You're in the forums!" I was like, "Say what?" Now, I have a forum account and I very rarely use it. But, yeah, apparently some person here called Arcantos2 had actually linked my previous video, linked to that over, that way. I'll get a card thingy, Mewtwo magic. Do your thing. Somebody, some kind fellow, had linked my previous video going through the interaction between, Discord from Sith Eternal Emperor and Galactic Legend Luke. Now, CG Doja Fett, who, as you will recall, is a brand new community manager. He's been with CG for a while, but he is new as a community manager, sort of operating alongside CG Crum. He has come in and responded to this post, and he's actually gone, and he's gone directly to one of the developers of the game, and he's actually gone through and completely ripped apart everything I said, which I'm completely fine with. We don't know how these kits interact underneath. It's not like it says it in the kits. So this sort of direct feedback, literal minute by minute, where he proves everything that I said was wrong, but I'm okay with that. He goes through minute by minute explaining in depth how this interaction is working, showing the calculations on Luke's max protection, showing how it's getting impacted by Discord, and just really giving us the exact sort of feedback that we should come to expect, or have come not to expect, from any sort of interaction that happens in this game. And personally, I really couldn't be happier. This, to me, is such a great thing for the community, showing that they put this investment into CG Doja Fett as a means to try and be more open and more frank and have faster communication lanes with us, the players, in this community. This, he's been in place, what, a day or two? A day or two has CG Doja Fett been in place as a community manager, and he's already on the forums, already chasing down developers, asking them, "Can you explain what's going on here? People are confused." This is brilliant. Is this a sign of things to come, guys? We've already seen how the AI in Luke is operating a little bit funky when he's on defense. He not seems to be passing inherited teachings, not spreading the Jedi lessons, learnings around his team, so he's not building up ultimate fast enough. Is this the sort of thing that we're going to get quick and fast and reliable communication on? Are we going to see things change? I don't know. I really hope so. Right now, this seems like positive feedback to me. So the only other thing that I really wanted to touch on here, guys, is to really explain what was going on in that sort of Jedi Luke, Sith Eternal Emperor Palpatine setup. So here we are. So here is the ability here, the Entwined Fates ability, the part where you link two characters together. So let's just make this full screen for now. And I'll just move myself down here. Okay, so, excuse me, what's going on is, right here, when these two characters have been linked, whenever they take a turn, they're going to have an additive multiplier applied to their max protection. So if you think about your base max protection will be what your base stats is for your character, plus anything that your mods apply. So it's base stats plus mods. Now, Luca R7 has roughly about 55,000 base protection. You can double that with mods if you go for a mod-heavy mod set. So it's about 100-110k, roughly. And then when you go into battle, then you'll have your additive modifiers, okay? So Galactic Legends Unique adds 70% to Galactic Legend Luke's max health and max protection. That's based on the number of relic levels he has. So R7, 10% per level, 70%. So that is 110 times 1.7. He also has his leadership ability, which grants 10% additional health and protection, doubled for Jedi. Okay, so he is a Jedi, so he gains 20% additional. That's 1.9 times his 110,000. Okay, So we can do a little bit of quick maths on that if I just grab my calculator, because let's assume he's 110,000 protection, just rounded off to round numbers here, and we've got an overall additive modifier of 1.9. So his effective max protection is roughly 210,000 at this point. Now, when a character with linked is linked and starts their turn, Palp's ability Sow Discord is going to apply a negative modifier of 0.8. So that 1.9 is going to reduce down to 1.1. So that 210,000 instead is going to be 110,000 roughly, is now going to be multiplied by times 1.1. So he's going to be at 121,000 roughly on protection. Now, he just took about 40,000 damage. That brings him down to 80,000. He took about 40,000 damage there, put him at 81,000 out of 121. So if we divide 81,000 by 121,000, it should be at about 65%, which is roughly where it's at. It looks maybe it's closer to like 70%, but we'll round and say that's probably about accurate, yeah? So he's at 81,000 protection out of about 120,000 at the moment. Okay. So now when Luke takes his turn, when Gas takes his turn coming up, now I know in the video I said he skips a turn, and that is based on the actual description of fear as per the game. It says they miss a turn. Now I know as far as mechanics go, it doesn't actually miss the turn, it just takes the turn with no action. And what that does is it still counts for everything such as debuffs, you know, when you have your debuffs expire, if you've got a buff for two turns, if you've got a debuff for X amount of turns, if you're hit by fear, and your TM fills out, it will ignore your turn, you'll take no actions, but the turn still counts, which I was aware of that interaction. So then, as you see, the max protection of Luke there has dropped again, and that is because that Sow Discord ability has interacted again, and it's taken us from 1.1 as our adaptive modifier to 0.3, okay? So now we've got 110,000 times 0.3, leaving us with about 33,000 as our total protection, total max protection remaining. And that's why it's decreased so much. Because we took that damage earlier, it has applied that as a percentage of the remaining protection left, and we're left with very, very little protection. Now, unfortunately, they were right in stating there is not a damaging effect. This is more like Gas's attack when he attacks someone with no protection. It lowers their max hit points by 20% whenever he attacks someone without protection. This is the same sort of thing, okay, except there's no damaging element whatsoever. So it does not get mitigated by the Galactic Legend unique. Little bit disappointing, because that is a large amount of protection to be losing off a Galactic Legend that does primarily use protection as his defining stat. Now, there are some positive sides to this. They did code the wording of Inherited Teachings, and specifically the true damage around it, to be that it is based off his base max protection, okay? So that's not going to be impacted by this ability here. The fact that Luke has no max protection doesn't mean you'll now do zero damage with Inherited Teachings. That's going to be based on your max protection at the start of battle. So if you've got 110,000, I believe it does 60%. 110,000, 60%, about 66,000. That's kind of the top end sort of damage you'll see on the true damage factor of Inherited Teachings. And honestly, it's not a heck of a lot of damage when you consider the amount of damage people can do on basics now. It's actually a damage decrease, but it does elevate some of the weaker physical Jedi, such as Shakti and Ezra and, you know, the likes of Aayla Secura and all these other Jedi that you perhaps wouldn't use in a standard GL lineup, but now have maybe a little bit more viability. Okay, so that's all I really wanted to touch on, guys. I wanted to give a quick shout out to CG Doja Fett. Like, he has gone above and beyond what we would normally expect for CG as far as communication goes, open and frank communication with the holotables. And I just think this is great and positive news. I might be disappointed by how this interaction is actually working as intended, but overall, I really cannot be too upset with the fact that we're getting some great, great communication here. And I really hope that this is how it's going to be going forward. So if you've got any comments for me down below, you can call me a fool and a moron for not understanding these kits for what they are and how the additive multiplier towards these stats take place. Happy to hear it. In the link to the description down below, we'll have links to my Twitter, to my Discord, to my Twitch channel. Please come and join, come follow, come say hi. I'd love to have a chat. And yeah, I will see you all in the next video. Peace out, guys. Just giving a quick shout out to my patrons. I appreciate each and every single one of you. And without your support, I wouldn't be doing this today. Thanks so much.